priests and the nobles, Tsar Nicholas of Imperial Russia with his wife and children. One day, all to find death in a bullet-swept cellar.
My grandmother, Pizania, was Nicholas II's sister. And my father was Nicholas II's eldest nephew. Territories were vast and they were incredibly powerful. Also, Nicholas was the head of the church. Already there was Bolshevik movements, and the Russian royal family were not as powerful as they were, say, in 1900.
On March the 15th, 1917, Tsar Nicholas II, supreme ruler of all the Russias, was forced to abdicate in the face of political and economic pressure that led in the end to total revolution.
Nicholas and his family were taken to Bolsk, and they were held, and then from Tobolsk they went to Yekaterinburg, which is where they eventually remained. I think the communists were worried that he might be put on the throne again, or at least might have more influence than what they were like.
His memory is what here during his lifetime, so accused of being inconsistent.
The children were Olga, Tatiana, Maria and Anastasia, and their brother Alexei, along with the Empress. Alexandra and Nicholas himself were all shot. After the fall of the Soviet Union, we heard on the grapevine that the bodies of Nicholas and family had been discovered in the swamp outside Yekaterinburg, and there was a movement that they would get a decent burial in St. Petersburg with the rest of their family. In 98, in July, one of my sons and myself went to St. Petersburg for the first time for the funeral of and there were between 52 and 56 Romanovs.
As the cortege approached the winter palace, the historic home of Romanov autocracy, it slows down, in keeping with the Russian tradition in which the puppets of the dead are driven past the place that was their last home.
Very long service, they were all